But women's liberation would say that unrelated sexuality is an achievement. Women can do now on a large scale sexually what men have been doing for centuries.
Well, I think that as far as there are still Victorian prudishness around, that is a good idea, but it is the least of the problem, because I would say that is now achieved in our modern world. A woman can live her sexual life as she likes, and so that is no longer the problem. Now comes the much bigger problem, namely a liberation of the heart. That is what should, that's the program of the next 50 years.
Liberation of the heart.
There are two possibilities of human connection. The one is technical, by the boss and the employé, the bus conductor and the passenger and so on, and that is organized by rules, and even organized nowadays by psychological rules. There are training programs for managers, how they manage the employees and so on, and that is all rationalized. And the one thing which is always left out is the liking and the disliking, and the feeling reaction. For instance, what does not count, a woman would sometimes like to say, this sounds all very logical, but I have a strong feeling against it. No, nobody would put any attention to that nowadays. If she cannot formulate it as a logical deduction, just to say, my feeling tells me, my feeling instinct tells me this is no good, then one just ignores it, one walks over her. And men do the same thing. Men have feelings too, but they ignore them. They think, they have a funny feeling in their stomach, and they think, oh, that is a jet lag or something, and they rationalize it away. They don't listen to the reactions of the heart. And that's what so many so-called primitive people or so-called underdeveloped countries, people of underdeveloped countries, reproach us, quite rightly. Because whatever their shortcomings are, they listen more to those feelings. To an Australian aborigine, you could still say, today I have a bad feeling, I won't move out of the camp. Or, that fellow seems to make a very good offer to us, but I somehow don't like him, and therefore I'll keep away from him. That you can tell still to an Australian aborigine, but if you say that to a white American businessman, he'll just think, oh, well, women.